Hush.
What's up, everyone? PyreHusky here, and welcome in my next guide video. Today is the one that probably you were waiting for. It's about creating first Chimera team. So the monsters you need are at least 3 Holy Swordsmen, 1 Druid. You can use also Pirate Captain if you, for example, have 2 Holy Swordsmen and 2 Pirate Captain, you can use them. If you have 4 Holy Swordsmen, of course, they are much better than Pirate Captain. Also, you need Golem, Jungle Heart, and Cerberus. All of those units are completely free to play. And now I will present you a build. Cerberus has to build, of course, attack, crit damage, attack, but to be honest, runes for him completely doesn't matter. You only have to focus on his passive skill, because when he hold, he increase attack and crit rate for all of your units for 2 turns. Another very important unit to get is Rock Golem because of his passive skill. Rock Golem, when being attacked, generate a shield for all allies equal to 5% of own max HP, and it lasts for 1 turn. But if you can see, it's more, it's 25% when he's fully skilled up, so that's really, really a lot, and he's the key unit for you to survive Chimera attacks. Another one is Jungle Heart, and her also 3rd skill, which increase duration of all allies' buffs by 1 turn. So that's really, really important. And now let's move to the unit that will help you the most. So there we go. We have Druid here. He has 226 speed, and that's really easy to get for early game players. If you focus, as I mentioned in my first video, this place, Luna Lake, Airplane, you can get here agile runes, and believe me, runes that you can get here are completely enough for your druid, because you have to focus to get about 200 speed plus. But it's really, really easy. You just need this rune to do plus 15, and the other runes, as you can see, just to put some speed on. And okay, Pirate Captain, he's really also important because his 1st skill is really, really strong, and his passive skill, the God of the Sea, turns into a sea owl which accompanies sailors. So whenever your unit is attacked, whenever your unit attack, the owl that he has on his head also strike and deal 70% of Pirate Captain attack. Okay, no more talking, let's go to the layer section. Okay, let's delete all of the units, of course, from the screen, not from my account. And let's go. So we have 4 Holy Swordsmen. At the start of the game, when you farm scenario, you will get plenty of attack runes. So just pull them all of your attack units and remember to have the same skill setup as I have. Of course, first skill is not changeable. Second skill has to be Fatal Blade because it increases Holy Swordsman crit rate for 2 turns. And his passive skill, Stalwart Warlord, which increase critical damage by 10% every single time he attack. Okay, so now we have 4 Holy Swordsmen, Druid, Rock Golem, Jungle Heart, and Cerberus. And that's my Jungle Heart. As you can see, she's not super fast, but you have to remember that she has to move before your Holy Swordsman. So she is 131 speed and my Holy Swordsman are less than 130. Okay, let's do 2 runs and after that I will show you more advanced team if you get some certain units. But now let's see. So we have cleanse buff with immunity, critical rate, and now bomb. Of course, all of my Holy Swordsmen are not sanctified. I delayed sanctify because to make it a little bit harder to kill. And of course, when you start play the game, you also has no chance to sanctify all of your Holy Swordsmen. And as you can see, there is no way to lose. 200 speed of Druid is required to put counter buff right before Chimera attack. So immunity, crit rate, now Jungle Heart extends buff, 4 Holy Swordsmen will move, and now counter buff from Druid. And as you can see, that's pretty good team. There is no way to wipe. And it's quite strong. Now in the next part, I will replace one of the Holy Swordsmen with Pirate Captain, because I know that that's really hard to get 4 Holy Swordsmen at start. If you play Arena, you can also convert some of your 4-star units to get Holy Swordsmen. Wonderful. Okay, some Crapion runes. Okay, so let's delay this guy and let's put Pirate Captain. And as you will see, he's really good replacement monster for Holy Swordsman, because he deals really quite good damage and also Chimera is dying fast. Alright, she flied up, she did some damage, but Rock Golem is absorbing everything. That I mentioned that he's the key unit here. With his shield, you are really, really safe. Okay, so let's sell this rune. And now let's go with some more advanced team. So let's say you have 4 Holy Swordsmen. And now you got, for example, an Elven Queen. If you got Elven Queen, you can just throw out Cerberus and also Rock Golem. You don't need him anymore. So you can put her here. And let's say pirate captain. Let's go. One more to go. And yep. She, Elven Queen, is one of the best monsters because she put an invincibility buff. Jungle Heart is still required here because she extends this buff, and that's the reason why your units can't die. And that's wonderful. Okay. One fly up and they're done. And they are done. Not they. The Chimera is done. And bam. Magnificent. Okay. If you got those units, of course you can replace Holy Swordsman with you can replace Pirate Captain with another Holy Swordsman. If you have more of them, like 5th, 6th and so on, you can just sanctify your Holy Swordsman to put some more damage on them. And alright, so now let's move to our almost ultimate team. So, if you got Elven Queen and you still have Druid, you can put the also Bone King, which increase damage quite good, but you have to focus on that passive skill, Piercing Halo. While alive, all allies' attacks have an 70% when his full skill up, it's 100% chance to deal more damage. Initial multiplier is 1 for every 30% of Bone King's critical damage. Increase multiplier by 0.05. And then damage is really, really strong. But now, let's put here Download. He's one of the best unit in the game, and it was also my first LND unit. So, if you got him, focus too. And don't look at the runes, of course. When you start, you will put fight runes here to increase your damage more, to get more of the conflict runes and to do some more damage by your Holy Swordsman. And now his third skill, Protective Breath, is one of the best because he put counter buff for 2 turns with attack buff. That's really amazing. And now let's do one test before an ultimate team that is currently the best possible. Alright, and 1, 2, 3. And now the counter. And now the counter buff. So, and let's go. Small army. Okay, they didn't crit. And now Chimera should be gone. Is she gone or not? Not. Okay, they didn't crit at all. Small fail during the video. But it doesn't matter. If your units crit, then Chimera dies with 2 simple attacks. Okay, so the ultimate team here is to take off one of the Holy Swordsmen, take off Jungle Heart, put in, and also Succubus. Succubus has to do her third skill, which Death Break Chimera and increase your attack. And now, let's begin the fun. Yin and Yang. And that's it. That's it. Okay. Let's do two more runs. And we are done. So, I highly recommend the first team. Killing Chimera will take you about 40 seconds to 1 minute. And time by time, try to increase your rune quality. And believe me, you will kill her much, much faster. Right, so let's kill Chimera last time and we're done. Thank you guys that you were patient and you survived to the last seconds of the video. I hope it will help to somebody with game progression. Of course, if you will have any question, feel free to ask in the comment section. I'm sure on 100% that I'll reply. Of course, if you would love to see something different in the videos, let me know. I'm open for any critique. And one more time, thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the bell and to subscribe my channel. And one more time, thank you to all of my guild members from the Gold Guild, which is one of the best in the earth. Okay, see you next time. Bye.